God is always moving and he is always speaking. And so when I hear revival, revival can happen every day. It's not this like, it can be a massive movement where thousands come to Jesus, but revival can also happen right here where you are, when you're witnessing to your coworkers, when you're witnessing to your family members, when you're living this life that is so kingdom oriented. Every single moment of your life is an opportunity for God to bring about revival. Halo semua, nama saya Stacy Guntoro dan saya begitu berterima kasih kepada Pastor Jonathan Hartopo dan the entire Now and Next Movement team for giving me this opportunity, the honor and the privilege of being able to share a little bit about my heart and also to share a devotional with you this morning. So when I was first asked to do this devotional, one of the things that I noticed right away is obviously the theme of the devotionals that we're doing, and it's revival starting from the home. I think that there is nothing more accurate about the way that God moves all throughout scripture, all throughout even the New Testament when Jesus comes to the earth, is the fact that he moved in such a way that homes were affected, families were affected, and everything changed. Jadi salah satu hal yang benar-benar, as I was praying into it and leaning into it, which now I am in a home. I'm actually currently in LA with my family. And super grateful actually for Pastor Danny, who is our IFGF LA pastor, for letting us stay here in the meantime. But that's truly home, right? It's like unexpected and things are constantly moving. But one of the things that the Holy Spirit really highlighted in my heart is I was really leaning into, Lord, like, what is it that you want me to share? And so that you would be honored and glorified through everything that I say, is I think that what, as I was praying into it, is the fact that we have to be awake. Revival all throughout history, as when we look at the Reformation, when we look at kind of like the birth of kind of Christianity, a lot of the movements were about partnering with the Spirit and saying yes to what God was doing here on earth. And so as I was praying into that, you know, like, what does this mean? What is revival going to really look like buat generasi kita dan buat dunia kita that we live in right now? A world that's so plagued with uncertainty, the policies and regulations consistently change. Karena dengan pandemi ini, pertama kita kira at the beginning of this year that things would go back to normal, when in reality, and then tahu-tahu the Delta variant came. So what does it mean to make meaning, to still be able to experience not just the external revival that God is doing, but also the internal revival, right? I fully believe that for the people of God to be truly awake to what he's doing on the outside, what's happening on the inside will really be able to, whether or not kita bisa melihat that revival in front of us depends on our inner spiritual life. So the verse that I want to share, the verses that I want to share is in John 1:35, Yohanes 1:35. So that's where we'll pick up, and I'm going to read from there. It says, the next day, again, John was standing with two of his disciples, and he looked at Jesus as he walked by and said, behold, the Lamb of God. The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following and said to them, what are you seeking? And they said to him, Rabbi, which means teacher, what are you seeking? Where are you staying? Sorry. Dia tanya, Rabbi, di mana? Where are you staying? He said to them, come and you will see. So they came and saw where he was staying, and they stayed with him that day, for it was about the 10th hour. You know, I think this is such a simple set of verses, kind of the text that, you know, the title of this part of scripture is called Jesus Calls the First Disciples. And one thing that I would like to pray for in all of our hearts as young people, as people who are constantly seeking to partner with the Holy Spirit, is that we would have the discernment and also the attention and the awakeness that John had in this passage. You know, the early followers of Jesus, John, Andrew, and Andrew, right? So One of the things that is super important to highlight in this passage is Jesus just says, come and you will see. One of the most important things that I would love to highlight, and again, so thankful to be able to share this, is the fact that God is always moving and he's always speaking. And so when I hear revival, revival can happen every day. It's not this like, it can be a massive movement where thousands come to Jesus, but revival can also happen right here where you are, when you're witnessing to your coworkers, when you're witnessing to your family members, when you're living this life that is so kingdom oriented. Every single moment of your life is an opportunity for God to bring about revival. And so I also wanted to highlight this quote by Dallas Willard, who is an extremely well-known, recognized theologian here in the U.S. He says in his book, Hearing God, which if you have not read yet, I highly encourage you to read it because it's an amazing book about listening to God in a world that constantly speaks. He says, our failure to hear his voice when we want to is due to the fact that we do not in general want to hear it. That we want it only when we think we need it. So, you know, guys, I one of the things that I would love to share is that this is such a hard season, and your pain, your concerns, your anxiety over this unending season of uncertainty, change, and just instability, God is present. He is present and he is ready to move in your life in large and small ways. And I just encourage you today that he is speaking, and wherever you are, I pray that the invitation of Jesus to come and you will see, that we'll be able to extend that to the people who are witnessing our lives right now. Come and you will see. And I believe that no matter where you are, in your homes, in your apartments, wherever you are living the world right now, revival is near and revival is coming because God is moving. So I pray that we are awake to what God is doing. Let's be awake and partner with the Spirit. So I'm going to end us off in prayer and let you go on with your day. Dear Heavenly Father, God, kita sangat berterima kasih. We are so thankful that you are a God that is actively moving, actively pursuing our hearts, actively inviting us to come and see. God, I pray that in this season of just truly uncertainty, Lord, that you would be truly the cornerstone of our lives and the foundation of our faith. That God, in this season of trial, Lord, that you would consistently refine our faith in such a way that to make it pure as gold. And I pray for every single person, Tuhan, yang mendengarkan this devotional today, Lord, that they would be encouraged, that they would be excited, that they would truly, Lord, shake themselves awake to what you are doing right here and right now. I believe, God, that, Lord, you will use every single person who is willing. And Lord, here we are. Here we are. We are ready for the daily revival. We are ready for what you are doing. Partner with us, God. Thank you, God. It is such an honor to be able to partner with you. We thank you, God, for who you are. We thank you for this invitation for us to come and see. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks, guys, and have an amazing rest of your week. Praying for all of you, and see you soon. God bless you.